listen to me.
What do you get when you guzzle down sweets?
Eating as much as an elephant eats.
What are you at getting terribly fat? What do you think will come of that?
I don't like the look of it.
Oompa loompa doompa-dee-da. If you're not greedy, you will go far. You will live in happiness too, like the oompa loompa doompa-dee-doo.
Doompa-dee-doo.
One Wonka bar, please.
This is Charlie's third try at finding one of the golden tickets hidden in an ordinary Wonka chocolate bar, since four out of the five have already been found.
I'm eating the Wonka bar and I taste something that's not chocolate. Coconut? No. Nougat? No. So I look and I find the golden ticket.
Since hearing about Mr. Wonka's tickets, I've switched from gum to chocolate. But now that I have one, I'm back on my gum chewing. Speaking of gum, I've been chewing on this piece for 3 months now. Pretty impressive, huh? I knew my daddy would get me that ticket because I always get whatever I want. Daddy, I want a pony next!
Of course I'd find a ticket. All you had to do was calculate exactly where it would be. As a gamer, I tend to have tons of skills that you can only dream of. Now let me get back to gaming.
I've got it!
Well, folks, it's the big day. People near and far have come to finally see who this mysterious Mr. Willy Wonka is and what he has planned for his winners. Daddy! Make the time go faster!
I've got my eyes on the prize.
I can't believe I'm actually here.
Welcome! Can all ticket holders and guests come forward? Greetings! I am Willy Wonka. No need to introduce yourselves. We do not have the time. Do not care. All right, everyone ready? Now, my dear children, everything you see in this room is edible. Go on. Try my grass, my tree branches, everything. But be careful where you step. Go on.
Ooh, the chocolate river.
Daddy, look at that boy.
Hey, little boy, don't touch that. My chocolate must not be touched by human hands. Now, on with the rest of the tour.
The group enters the inventing room, but Mr. Wonka wants to show them a specific invention.
Watch this.
You mean that's it? All the work just for that?
Do you even know what it is?
It's gum.
Yeah, it's a stick of the most amazing and sensational gum in the whole universe. Know why? Know why? Because this gum is a full three-course dinner all by itself.
Why would anyone want that?
It will be the end of all kitchen and all cooking. Just a little strip
of Wonka's magic chewing gum, and that is all you will ever need, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. This piece of gum happens to be tomato soup, roast beef, and blueberry pie.
It sounds great.
It sounds weird.
It sounds like my kind of gum.
I'd rather you didn't. There's still one or two things that's a little...
I'm the world record holder in chewing gum. I'm not afraid of anything. Wow. This is amazing. Tomato soup. I can feel it running down my throat. It's changing. Roast beef with baked potato. Crispy skin and butter.
A little concerned about the
blueberry pie and ice cream.
That part.
What's happening to her nose? It's turning blue. Your whole nose has gone purple.
Well, I did say I haven't gotten it quite right. It's the blueberry pie that does it. I'm terribly sorry. Well, that's unfortunate. On to the next room.
The group enters a nut sorting room as an assembly of trained squirrels work to distinguish between a good and bad nut.
These trained squirrels are not for sale. Do not touch their nuts because it will make them crazy.
Daddy! I want a squirrel. Get me one of those squirrels now. If you don't get me a squirrel, I will do it myself.
Oh no, what are the squirrels doing to her?
Oh my goodness.
She is a bad nut after all.
I think the squirrels are taking her down the garbage chute.
They're taking her to where all the other bad nuts are. Let's move on.
The group enters the TV room.
This is the testing room. My very latest and greatest invention, television chocolate. Imagine sending a real chocolate bar through the television all ready to eat.
It's impossible. You don't understand anything about science. First of all, there's a difference between how much power it would take to convert energy and matter would be like 9 atomic bombs.
Ugh, again with all the mumbling and attitude. Seriously, I can't understand a single word you're saying. Okie dokie, I shall now send a bar of chocolate from one end of the room to the other by television.
It's gone.
Told ya. And that bar of chocolate is now rushing through the air above our heads in a million little tiny pieces. Come over here. Come on. Watch the screen. Go on. Take it.
It's just a picture on the screen.
Scared cat. You take it. Go on, just reach in and grab it. Eat it. Go on, it'll be delicious. It's the same bar. It just got a little smaller on the journey. That's all.
It's great.
So imagine you're sitting at home watching television and suddenly a commercial will say, Wonka's chocolate bars are the best in the world. You don't believe us? Well, try one for yourself. And you simply reach out and take it.
Well, what about people?
Why would I want to send a person? They don't taste very good at all.
Don't you realize what you've invented? It's a teleporter. It's the most important important invention in the history of the world, and all you think about is chocolate. You think he's a genius, but he's an idiot. But I'm not.
Hey, little boy, don't push the button.
There he is.
Mike, the most important thing that we've ever learned, the most important thing we've learned as far as children are concerned, is never to look in the mirror.
Let's go check the television and see what we get. I sure hope no part of him gets left behind.
Sorry.
Oh, my dear boy, you've won!
Really? That's so cool. What room are we going to next?
Up and out.
What's up and out?
You have just won my entire factory. It's all yours.
Really? That's great. I would love to take my family with me.
Oh, no. No parents allowed. Chocolatiers work alone.
Well then, I don't want it. I'm fine. I wouldn't trade my family for any amount of chocolate.
Huh. Maybe I should go give my papa a visit.
It was on this day that Willy Wonka repeated his offer to Charlie, who accepted on one condition. In the end, Charlie Bucket won a chocolate factory, but Willy Wonka gained something even better, a family.